The Find service is designed to query a DICOM server to find patients, studies, series, or instances. All DICOM communications start with an associate exchange. Then comes the Find request, which contains two important parts, the matching keys and the return keys. The matching keys are a set of tags which will be used for the query. The server will try to find in its database objects which match those tags. The return keys are a set of tags which we want to retrieve from the server. Typically, we could have a patient name or ID in the matching keys with the study instance UID in the return keys to find all studies for a patient. The response will contain, in addition to the usual message ID and status, the matching keys and return keys, this time filled with the values from the items found. Finally, the association is released. We can use the Find SCU program from DCM4SHI to test this service. We see that there are lots of options in this application, which can also be used for worklist management and other things. We can also use DICOM files or XML files to specify the matching and return keys, but we'll keep it simple and use the command line options. The M option specifies the matching keys and the R option the return keys. We can use the hexadecimal tag values or their names. Let's build a simple query. We want to find, on the Hortan DICOM server, all studies with a patient name that start with Wickler and retrieve their study instance UID. Looking at the result in the command line, we can see after the associate part that the cfind request contains three tags for the query. The query retrieve level, which tells that we want to find studies, the patient name, with the string we want to match, and the study instance UID, which is left empty so that the server can fill it. In the response, we can see that the patient name and the study UID have been updated with their correct values from the study found in the database of the server. We can also see that we have a status different from zero. We can use the online documentation to check the meaning of the status. We can see that the status number, which is FF00 in hexadecimal, corresponds to a pending status. The server will reply to a find request with the results with this pending status. And when it has finished and has no other result left, it will send a success status, which is zero. ...of the cfind service in Java using the PixelMed library. We created a client application with a simple interface where we can write a patient name and click on a cfind button to generate a request. The button has an event handler, the method which is called when the user clicks on it. The handler retrieves the text from the patient name's text field. Then it calls the doFindSCU method from an instance of a class called DICOMSCU. It's a class that we created to handle all SCU operations for our DICOM client. In the doFindSCU method, we first create a handler, which will determine what happens when we receive studies when we do a cfind. We'll take a closer look at that class later. Then, we fill the identifier, which is a list of DICOM attributes corresponding to the matching and return keys. The patient name has a value and will be used as a matching tag, whereas all the other tags we put have no value and will therefore be return keys. Finally, we start the Find subclass SCU class from PixelMed. The constructor takes parameters defining the target service provider, in this case Hortan, as well as the attribute list and a reference to the handler. Going one step further, in the handler, we have a method which will be called for each response received by the cfind request. In this method, we print all the received tags onto the terminal and fill an array list with the study UIDs. The list is returned by the doFindSCU method once the find subclass SCU is finished and the communication is closed. Back in the main window, the list of study UIDs is added to a list model which is linked to a JList object so that we can see the results. When we execute the program, the main window is started. We fill the patient name and click on cfind and immediately see the corresponding study appear in the JList. Looking at the terminal, we can see that the find SCU identifier handler was called and all the tags we put in the identifier were filled with the values from the DICOM file. The next service you want to look at is the CMove, which involves three entities. The Move SCU connects to the server with the usual association and a CMove request, which contains matching keys as well as the destination application entity title. The destination needs to be known by the server, which will have a lookup table with the corresponding host and ports that it needs to use for this particular destination. The server then uses the matching keys to find corresponding studies and use a CStore operation to send those studies to the destination. Note that the Hortan server, in this case, acts both as the service provider to the Move SCU and as a service user to the store SCP. It responds with a success or failure notification, and the Move SCU can release the connection. Let's again look at this in the Java code. We have a CMove button, once again with an event handler. The handler will retrieve the currently selected series UID from the result of the cfind operation and called the doMoveSCU method of the DICOMSCU class, which is already used for the find. In the doMoveSCU method, we create an attribute list in which we put tags which indicates that we want to move an entire study and the UID of that study. The usage of the Move subclass SCU from PixelMed can be found in the documentation with examples on how to use it. In the constructor of the Move subclass SCU, we provide the location of the server, our application entity title, and the destination application entity title of the CStore. In the configuration file of the Hortan server, we can check that it knows both the Move SCU, which will be the Java program, and the store SCP entities, which as we can see will run on the same machine as Hortan, since it has the 127.0.0.1 IP address, which is the local host, on port 11.112. If we test this, we can see that it doesn't work. That's because at the moment there is no StoreCP server running on this machine. There is therefore no destination available for the CMove. We can use DCM4SHI to quickly set up a simple CStore service provider. We have to make sure that the port is the same as the information in the Orton configuration. Now that the StoreCP server is running, we can try the CMove again. We see in the terminal of the StoreCP that it received the CStore request, which was successful. The default behavior of the StoreCP program is to store the file on the disk directly in the current directory. We can see that the received file is indeed there and that the move operation worked. In the next video, we'll look more closely at the service provider part of DICOM Communications.